Welcome to Microsoft Project 2016 tutorials. In this video, I will show you how to enter predecessor information. The predecessor information will be used to define the sequence of activities and how they depend on each other. We can enter this information into Microsoft Project entry table and see how it will change the Gantt chart on the right. We only need to enter the predecessor information for the lowest level activities and not for the major deliverables. The first task in this project is interviewing the users. It does not have any predecessor, so we leave the predecessor cell blank. Once the interviews have been completed, we can define the performance requirements for the software. So interviewing the users is a predecessor to defining the requirements. Therefore, activity 3 is a predecessor for activity 4. We will enter a 3 here in the predecessor column. Once we have defined the requirements, we can design the logic. So activity 4 is a predecessor for activity 6. Once we have designed the logic, we can design the database. So activity 6 is a predecessor for activity 7. Now that all of the predecessor information has been entered, we have successfully placed all the activities in a meaningful sequence. Some activities may require that more than one activity be completed before it can begin. For example, integrating software and hardware can only begin once code A, code B, and assembling the hardware have all been completed. If we scroll over to view the Gantt chart, we can see that it has developed further after we have entered the predecessor information. We can see when each of these activities starts and finishes relative to this timeline. Also, Microsoft Project has summarized all of the information entered for the entire project. In this row, we can see that our project is estimated to take 24 days to complete. Here, days means work days. Okay, that is how to enter the predecessor information in Microsoft Project 2016. If you like this video, please subscribe and share. This is Yong, and I'll see you in the next video.